Mr. Raghunath Mishra, Chairman, DJM School, Mr. Pratap Jena, Manager, DJM School, Madam Sandhya Jena, Principals, Vichitranjan Barisal, Additional Managers, Members of the Managing Committee, President of Lions Clubs, Teachers, Staffs, Children, Young Girls and Boys, Parents, Ladies and Gentlemen, Members of Media, I express my greetings to you on the auspicious occasion of 71st Republic Day. Today, I was observing Madam Principal and your manager spoke about Independence Day and Republic Day. Usually, children get confused. So it is very good that they explain to you. But one thing I want to tell, why this 26 January was selected, many of you may be knowing from history books that in 1930, Indian National Congress declared Purna Swaraj, that is full independence. That was on 26 January 1930. So, to commemorate that particular day, after the constitution was drafted and adopted in our Constituent Assembly on 26 November 1949, on 26 January 1950, we accepted that day as the Republic Day. So, every year we are observing. Children, our constitution, which was adopted on this date, is a time tested. We have spent 71 years, and during these 71 years, this constitution has seen many ups and downs. This is the longest written constitution of the world, having more than 100 amendments to accommodate the aspiration of the people of this country. But it has remained able to keep our democratic system perfect. Somebody told, whatever lacuna is there in a democratic system, it is the best form of government, and our constitution has given it. Children, you know our border, Pakistan, on the same day, 14th August, they got independence, and on 15th, we got independence. How their constitution was sabotaged. How many times their constitution was suspended and military rules were imposed. But it didn't happen in our country. Why? Because we must remember the father of our constitution, Ambedkar, the way he has written it, in consultation with the group of eminent lawyers and persons of at that time, that it is not only stable, gradually it is picking up, and our progress, both economically, militarily, as a upward trend. As a famous economist told, by 1940-2047, our economic growth will definitely surpass the economy of United States of America. So, children, at that time we may not be here, but EU people will lead the country at that time. You will be in the helm of affairs. So, now it is your responsibility to think, to work in such a way that the country will become a superpower, a Vishwaguru, a knowledge center of the world. You must know how our ancient history was, how we feel proud for our civilization. Only during the foreign rules, during the British period, We are taught our culture and civilization is bad. We are taught English. We are taught to hate our culture. And that shadow of colonialism is still continuing. आपको जानकर बहुत गर्व होगा कि इस देश में हमारा जो एंसेस्टर थे, जो साइंटिस्ट थे, जो फिलोसोफर थे, जिसी को हम ऋषि मुनि बोलते हैं, ये लोग बहुत दिन पहले ये दिस अर्थ इज एन स्फेरिकल शेप, इट इज नोन टू देम, बट वी स्टडी, एटलीस्ट आई हैव स्टडीड इन माई जो हिस्ट्री बुक, साइंस बुक, सम यूरोपियन साइंटिस्ट आर डिस्कवर्ड दैट अर्थ इज एन स्फेरिकल शेप. बेसिक ट्रांसलेशन ऑफ ज्योग्राफी इज भूगोल. भू मीन्स पृथ्वी, गोल मीन्स स्फेरिकल. एंड इफ यू सी the third avatar of our dash avatar, who is lifting the earth from the sea, it is in a spherical shape. Thousands and thousands years back, our ancestors were knowing about it. Our ancestors were knowing about these molecules and atoms. It is known as Anu and Paramanu. Our ancestors were knowing about the structure of atom. There are three fundamental particles in the atom. They gave it the status of Trinity. Somebody told it in Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwar, something. But universe is made up of these three fundamental particles, were known in thousands, thousands, thousands years back. But we are taught that Dalton told us atomic structure and it has got three things. You should be proud of that. You have a great, great civilization. You are born in a great civilization and you have to continue that upward. Our ancestors long back were able to calculate solar eclipse. Astronomically, we are so strong. Odisha, Pathani Samantaray, he was able to measure the distance of a hill from a distance, for which one English man was surprised. You know the Everest mountain height was not discovered by Everest. It was not calculated by Everest. It was calculated by Mr. Sarkar, who was forcefully removed from his service, and his articles were written by Everest, and now we are calling it Mount Everest because he calculated the height of that mountain. It is wrong. If you go into history, you will see how we are made fools by Western civilization, by the Britishers. This is the time we should awaken, we should come up, we should understand. So, about our civilization, I request you all to read our history, be proud of it, and carry on. If you see, if you compare yourself in the world, हम किसी से कम नहीं है, हम सबसे ऊपर है. ये हमको सोचना है, हमारा दिल में लेना है. हम कभी हमको इंफीरियर कभी नहीं सोचना है, हम छोटा हमको कभी नहीं सोचना है. ऑलवेज वी आर एवव, आर एंसेस्टर्स वर ऑलवेज एवव, एंड वी आर ऑलवेज एवव एनीबॉडी इन द वर्ल्ड. इन द इकोनॉमिक फ्रंट, एज आई टोल्ड यू, इन बाय 1948 our economy will surpass and it will become the highest GDP in the world. On this occasion, I remember Swami Vivekananda, who always used to give advice to the youngster, to the children, few intellectuals also. The power is within you. You only, it is your responsibility to wake up. So the common saying of Vivekananda, arise, awake, stop not till goal is not achieved. Please understand it. Always feel yourself capable of doing anything. There is no question of unsuccessfulness. कोई अनसक्सेसफुल हो ही नहीं सकता है, वो कोशिश करता है तो. कोशिश करने वाला कभी हार ही नहीं मानता है. टेक अप वन आइडिया, मेक दैट वन आइडिया योर लाइफ, थिंक ऑफ इट, Dream of it. Let the brain, muscle, nerve, every part of your body be full of that idea and leave every other idea alone. This is the only way to success. And you will definitely be successful. आज इसी अवसर पर मेरा सामने स्टूडेंट्स बैठे हैं, छोटे छोटे बच्चे हैं, यंग बॉयज एंड गर्ल्स हैं, फरवरी में एग्जाम है, पेरेंट्स भी आए हैं. मैं एक चीज बताना चाहता हूँ, एक सुस्त समाज सृष्टि करने के लिए, एक सुस्त समाज का उत्तम मानव सृष्टि करने के लिए समाज में तीन वस्तु का आवश्यक होता है. एक है पेरेंट्स, सेकंड है टीचर्स, थर्ड है सोसाइटी. सो इट इज माय अपील टू द पेरेंट्स दैट टीच, मेक योर चाइल्ड इज अ बेस्ट ह्यूमन बीइंग. ट्राई टू मेक योर चाइल्ड ए बेस्ट ह्यूमन बीइंग. ये कहते हैं संघर्ष पिता से सीखते हैं, संस्कार माता से सिखाता है, ज्ञान शिक्षक देता है, बाकी सब समाज सिखा देता है. तो इसीलिए आज जो पेरेंट्स इधर बैठे हैं, ये लोग बच्चों को संघर्ष सिखाएंगे. ये लोग को कभी डरा कर वो साइकिल में इधर मत जा, गिर जाएगा, वो करेगा. एक्चुअली आवर माइंड इज फुल ऑफ टू सेव अवर चिल्ड्रेन, ऑलवेज वी ट्राई, बट दैट यू शुड फॉरगेट. यू सी हाउ आवर चाइल्ड कैन फाइट एंड गो अप. माता से संस्कार. इफ यू ऑब्जर्व ए चाइल्ड बिकम जस्ट लाइक हिज मदर. सो आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑल मदर्स टू टीच गुड संस्कार, गुड आइडियल्स. And ultimately the teachers, they are everything, they give the knowledge. So teachers should be ideal. I don't want to spend much time to speak about what should be the quality of the teachers and students and the parents. In this occasion I give you the best wishes and hope that your coming examination in the month of February, it is full of examination, I believe, starting from class 6 to 12, everybody is in tension. Remember one thing, examination is not a turning point of your life. It is important, yes, it is important, but if you don't get good marks or if you don't become successful, that is not end of the game. God has kept something better for you. I'll complete my speech with my personal experience, which usually one should not tell. When I was studying in Ravensa College, I appeared for MBBS examination. I failed, I could not get all. Everybody in my room, they got MBBS in SCB Medical College. There are three medical colleges at that time. But I could not get. I was so frustrated and all. So somebody advised me, ki, you study that. So I study. So God has something else for me to serve the people. So if you don't get IIT, if you don't get NIT or NET, don't worry. God has given a better place for you, better way for you. Okay, thank you. इस खुश अवसर पर मैं सबको अनुरोध करता हूँ, मेरा साथ भारत माता की जय 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 तीन बार बोलेंगे. भारत माता की, भारत माता की, भारत माता की जय हिंद, जय हिंद, जय हिंद. धन्यवाद.
Kind words. Now I request the Honorable Chairman of the school, Shijita Raghunath Mishra, to speak a few words. Sir, please.
A very good morning and happy greetings for the Happy Republic Day to all of you. To all of you present here, including the anxious parents who are sitting by the side. Esteemed chief guest, Sri Sisir Mishra, ex-DGP Jammu and Kashmir. Distinguished guests on the dais, my colleagues, teachers, and dear students. It is indeed a very important day for all of you, those who live in India and abroad, Indians, because on this day we gave ourselves the constitution which is the best, considered to be the best in the world, because it contains all the essential ingredients, essential aspects of all the good constitutions in the world, and also the essential and very important scriptures in the world, including Mahabharata, Ramayana, Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavad, etc., Srimad Bhagavad, etc. Because this is the sacred book which will give you all the answers to all your problems at all the time. So, dear students, whether you are in the science stream, art stream, commerce stream, or any other stream, you must have the rudimentary knowledge of the Indian Constitution, which has been so laboriously drafted by eminent sons of the soil, and they have taken 2 years, 11 months, and 17 days to draft this Constitution, taking all the very good provisions of all the good constitutions in the world. This is the day of rededication, because we have heard a lot, we are hearing a lot, speeches are too many and plenty, but our work, our performance, our achievement are not commensurate with the speeches we make and the loud noises we make. So on this day, I will urge upon you to take sankalpa, resolution, to do your duty that is the best. Because unless you do your work properly, perfectly, and to the best of the society, then everything becomes meaningless. Winston Churchill had predicted that India will be disintegrated within a few years if you hand over the reins of administration to these buffoons. But you see what has happened. In no time, India will be superpower and maybe the number one country in the world. That is the contribution of our ancestors, efforts of the leaders, efforts of responsible citizens, efforts of students, efforts of everybody. So we have a greater responsibility to keep up our traditions, to keep up our social customs, and to adhere to all the values of life. In this connection, I will request you to please remember your fundamental rights along with your fundamental duties. These are all enshrined in the Constitution and also the directive of state policy. Unless you are aware of this, you will do something wrong which will not only harm you but also to the society. Now you see, a number of schemes are being done by the government, state government, central government, any other government including municipal governments. But unless these are preserved and unless they are strengthened, these become only ephemeral and meaningless things. On this happy occasion, I must pay my rich tribute to the millions of freedom fighters who have given us this independent India, where we are proudly saying that I am an Indian. They are, you must know, the father of the nation, Mahamanu, Mahatma Gandhi, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, then Maulana Abul Kalam Azad. In Odisha also, you must remember Dr. Mahatab, who unified Odisha, following the example of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, whose contribution to the nation, in unifying the nation, is worthwhile and world famous. In Odisha, there are also thousands and thousands of freedom fighters, beginning from Birsa Munda, and the tribal leaders, those who sacrificed their life without hesitation, including the signage created by Subhas Chandra Bose, who is also a son of our soil here from Udia Bajari, Katak. So friends, you should not forget any of them, those who have contributed in any way to the independence of this great country, the results of which we are enjoying almost every day. So, I will request you to do your duty wherever you are. Never mind that you are a small person. Never mind that you are merely a student. Never mind that being a teacher you cannot do anything. Never mind that we are in a combined manner will not be able to fight the enemy. But all these are false. Every collaborative effort, every collaborative document has its own meaning. And please collaborate in all good things and build your character so that everything will come out of that only. Unless you have a good life, a good sanskar, and a good beginning, you cannot be a good member of the good society which will be ultimately contributing to the greatness of India again. India will be number one, there is no doubt about it. And please do not hesitate to contribute your mind to the nation building. Thank you, gentlemen, thank you, ladies, and thank you, parents, who have made time to come over here to see the achievements of the children, to watch the achievements of the school, to watch the work of the management, and to rededicate themselves to the nation.